Welcome back to the TSSSR, my friends, and today maybe a little bit of a special episode again. We want to look at the Federation we have, and we want to change it. Because we are close to taking over the political lead in that, and so we want to quickly reform it to get a very high influence in it. What we need to do there is we need first to get the centralization too high. Everyone likes that. Let's get this started. We'll vote yes. Because we want to take over, and we are on the brink of taking over diplomatically. I mean, the Alarians are still better, but they have proven to be a good leader, so it's okay. Our vote succeeded. These two didn't do anything, they abstained probably. Let's have a look now. Now, what can we unlock? First, we want to change the succession to strongest, if that is possible. But what do we need for that? We need a couple of people. We need the Stellar Kingdom of Alaria to say yes. Thwapea. And the Yagyan Shroompire. I mean, we need at least two of them. Because we have a majority. No, we have an unanimous vote for now. For war declaration. And to invite members. So I want to get this to strongest. They don't want to change it. The Crux Coin wants to change that. So we'll see. What we're gonna go for now is we'll bribe them all. An immense amount of favors. First the Thwapia, then the Yagyans, then the Stellar Kingdom of Alaria. So Thwapia, Yagyans, Kingdom of Alaria. They will be easiest here. Under your gentle guidance. Yeah, we want you to give us favors. We can have 10 favors. Let's see how we get to this point. They don't need food. Need alloys. Goodness me. Consumer goods. A little bit. They like consumer goods a little bit. That's good. We have tons of them. Maybe we can do something with throw. Ah. Yeah, that's that. Look at that. That's nice. But maybe we can use something we have a ton of, so let's get started with a consumer goods. So 14,000 consumer goods, that's the first thing. My goodness me. Do they need energy credits? Oh, they like energy credits. That's fine. Always use your most expendable resources first. Here we go. Ah, get it a little bit down. Whoa, you never know. You never know when you need them. Ah, no, let's leave it at plus two. So, swap here. Oh, that's just nice. So, we have the swap here. We want the Shroompire too, and then the Kingdom of Alaria. Let's see. Offer a trade deal. We want your favors, my friends. And five favors from you. Or do we already have five favors? I'm not sure anymore. I believe so. Maybe they also want consumer goods. Let's see. Yeah, they like consumer goods. That's great. Because we have tons of consumer goods, you see. We're just selling them. Oh, consumer goods might be enough. Had to get this to plus two, so. We're into this. Great, so we've used up all our consumer goods. Now let's get to the Yagyan Shroompire. There are plans right now. 10. Yeah, we want 10 favors. You look like you're hungry. No? Okay. Minerals? Not at all. We also don't have enough minerals. Maybe energy credits. Everybody needs energy credits. No, apparently not. Oh, then we come to alloys. Alloys they like. Consumer goods. We still have a couple of consumer goods. They don't like consumer goods. We don't want to give away alloys. What do we have here? We have volatile modes now. We have a good production of volatile modes. Let's see. Ooh. But I think it's less intrusive for us to use this row because we really don't have any use for it. And it's going to be much cheaper to use this row. Here we go. 10 favors for 330 throw. That's pretty cheap, I got to say. So let's see. Are we getting into this or what? Yes. Yes. Great. The terms are reasonable. Ah, oh, let's get into the Federation. Let's see, we want strongest. Ah, the succession power law. So let's see how we get this to the positives. Six favors. Goodness me. Why am I bribing them with everything I have? Now that could be a question. Because if anyone says no, then the cohesion falls, theoretically. So we're gonna go for that. Now make everyone the strongest. Of course, we're gonna be the strongest soon, and then strongest succession type succeeded. Very nice. So let's see. The succession term. President currently are they? They are definitely strongest at the moment. We want this to be at status change. So when we take over, we want this to be ours. Status change, and we're supported by two of them for that. Succession power is based on diplomatic weight. We could change this, but not for a couple of years. Of course, we just changed this to strongest, so apparently this is in the same category or something like that. See if there's other things. Vote weight. We also want to change vote weight. But we don't have to really. We can also just bribe them into votes, and it might be good to do so. Invite members, war declarations. Yeah, I mean it's not good for the Federation if it's not an unanimous vote or if the president decides. So we just want to be the leader of this thing. It would take a very long before we would be the next one if this is a rotation. So we don't want it to be a rotation. We're very confident in getting to be the strongest later on. So we want this to be status change. And then the next thing we also want to enable the migration treaties, but let's first do the status change. We just need a little bit to bring them on our side. So we change that. We have to be very careful because this always takes down cohesion. And we're gonna invest in more invoice into this to keep our cohesion at a good level. Now, free migration treaties with everyone have a very big advantage. It just saves influence. So we're gonna enable this. Everyone's gonna say yes. So we're good. Free migration treaties. So let us see. And there's more things we could change. Like we could change the fleet contribution too high if we want so. The Federation has an extensive collaborative military effort. That would be cool. Because why? Because as you can see, this Entente Coordination, that is what we have here. The amount we contribute toward the Federation naval capacity counts for twice as much. And our members have that too. But we really don't trust the AI's ability to steer ships. So we're not going to use this until we are president. We could go for president decides everywhere, but I think we can just live with a majority vote. We can bribe them any time with the special resources that they don't get, like throw or something like that. So there's that. Now we have to look at the levels. Yeah, and as you can see here, the cohesion impact is kind of terrible. So we need to assign another envoy. Maybe we can put him here. I mean, the Evaxian Union. Yeah, they are there, but really. Yeah, it's better that way. It's better that we keep the cohesion high. Otherwise, we might lose a level, I think. I think it works that way. So, there's that. We have this safe. We have a lot of influence then. It's all gonna be nice now. Here's the overview. We're leading on economy. Just in a no contest. In fleet and in tech, we are behind. In diplomatic points, we are relatively close to our leaders here. Now, to get us to be the president, we need to overtake them by 25%, which means we need to have diplomatic points like a lot. 130,000 or something like that. As you can see, it's based on fleet power, it's based on technology and economy. So we definitely have a point there. When we get good economy and get good technology, we are ready to take over. We don't even need a fleet, but the fleet will come. As you see, we're second in fleet already, and no, we're building already, and it will all be good. So that is for the reforms. So with that, let's continue our fight in another way. So see, we've already used up all the minerals we could for our expansions here. And let's just see what we can do. We have a lot of
Our research has progressed.
mega stuff going still. We'll see what goes on there. The Psi jump drive! Finally! We've got the Psi jump drive. We got it from the Shroud. The Psi jump drive harnesses the Psi energies emitted by the crew to force the vessel through the very fabric of reality, instantly jumping vast distances. Which is extremely good for us. And, we'll just see what we can get going with this. I'd really have a little bit of edict duration. And we should reform our fleets now so we can upgrade them. Like this is 70%. This has a higher jump drive range, which is just great. It's just super good. Hopefully we don't have more like this. Not really. Yeah. So we've got this. We'll see that we'll use it everywhere. And it also uses, it harnesses the psionic potential of the ship's crew to warp the local space continuum, eliminating the distance between the point of origin and the destination, supposedly. Here we go. Must be able to jump a lot better and a lot quicker. So we want this on everything. We can delete that glory thing. Yeah, I mean the pre-made, the ships that the AI designs, let me tell you, they are just terrible. You don't need to choose them. It's just specialize in one weapon and adapt your computer to it and you're fine. We have our different titans. Yeah, we cannot warp the stations. Not yet. The iron cannon. Yeah, you can also edit the iron cannon. It seems like you should. Look at these shields. And let's have a look at that. Aha. Would have better tracking with that, but really the iron cannon is not about tracking. Even if you have better tracking with that, that's not going to work. So safe in combat computer is fine. Longbow. I don't know. Yeah, let's have it at that. The Soviet siege juggernaut is fine, but we need a jump drive. Yeah, that juggernaut is not fine. And yeah, that's gonna be it. It's gonna be pretty good. Here we go. We can start upgrading this. That's also at the point where Gray will supposedly stand back and defend the home territory. And Tomato and Swarm declared war on Honeybee Unity. Now it's getting real. And now there will be a peace with the Avanian Remnant soon, probably. And this is our time that we're given to prepare for the grand conflict. Because if they really take a bite out of the Honeybee Unity, then everything is too late. They're also at war with the Elven now. And the Elven have significant fleets now. Absolutely significant fleets. They have really big fleets. The fleets of the Honeybee Unity are also there. They are not at their home. They're here. And they're already moving. So they're already mobilized. I'm not sure how good this is for the Antomatons. I really hope it's not that good. So let's see what we can get here. Trade. Yeah, maybe a little bit of gas. What do you gas?
Construction finalized. So. Our research has progressed.
And more research. Ah, yeah. Better energy weapons. Let's get some more monies. And better research. Better mineral income. Now let's go for better armor. We're getting there. We're also getting good armor. Let's see.
Ships upgraded.
So we've got this. First fleet has been fully upgraded. What's going on here? Oh yeah, we have too few minerals again, isn't it? That? Yeah, it's probably that. It's probably that. Too few minerals. We're selling so much right now. We're only buying 100 of these. That will change. Look, these stations are already full. We only need to control if they have still, yeah, they have this utopian communal housing. We need to replace it again with something that works. We have still some room there, so we can add another alloy stuff factory, foundry. Don't need that here, that is full. That's the same here. Yeah, some time in the not so far future, we might need to change free movement policies. But we'll see. I mean, as long as it's okay, we are not concerned about the unemployed. They give us research too. Due to the utopian abundance. That's basically universal income. A little bit of extras.
Ships upgraded.
So everyone can have a small lab and do what he wants. It's absolutely the thing we want for our society. So everyone can profit. And everyone can contribute to something greater. Habitat is complete. Yay! Spirit of equality. Oh, we want a gate here as well, right? Are we? Is there a ship flying over, making a gate there? I hope not. Let's see. Let's control this. Otherwise, we'll have two gates. That would be terrible. No, 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 no one flying over to build a gate. That's good. Where do we want the gate? Somewhere here. Here we go. Now we need someone to settle on this. Hoo, hoo, hoo. Look at the Eldar. Now even cybernetic. What have you done, guys? What have you done? That's more than odd, but okay, they get more army damage and a bigger leader lifespan. And they already have. They have now a leader lifespan of plus 120 years. Oh. Gotta be crazy.
Ships upgraded.
Nice. Force is getting upgraded. Soviet Speed Force, where are they? They're also at the Sol system at the moment. Getting the upgrades in. Someday, when the days begin to change again. Genius upgrading. And oh, expertise Voidcraft for Joseph Laurent. Which is pretty good. So it was a big help that the Alarians are strongest at the moment and that they're leading at the moment in changing the Federation laws. But as you see, we're getting there. We're definitely getting there. Also with the t technology and whatnot, I think we'll be good with the technology, especially. Of course, we have it coming really, really quickly now, and we're doing everything in our power to keep it that way. Oh, talking about everything in our power, we want to look if we can maybe reverse engineer again. Yeah, arcane insights for 60 months. 5 years of 10% more research speed is pretty good. And let's have another ancient fad going. So we can celebrate diversity of, I don't know, we can just celebrate happiness. Look at
Together
the elven.
Together we will build a brighter future.
Proclamation broadcasts, yeah. Better edict duration. And here we're gonna go for food, I don't know. We have enough food at the moment. We have still a big bucket full. Give us more starbase capacity. Here we go. We also have the advantage compared to other empires out there. Yay! That the Illyrians are also seemingly good in energy weaponry. Let's find out. It stays that way. Gateways. Gateways, gateways, gateways. They are coming. They're coming everywhere. It's really, we need to have them, like, I think now. Now is a good time. Because they are really even more important than the habitats at the moment. Now that war might break out at any moment. Now, let's see if they can do something there, if they have to humiliate. They haven't taken that yet. They're still bombarding them into oblivion. That is such a shame. Is the speed force doing? It's doing fine. Getting even more quick. Yeah, Katya Petrenko is pretty quick already with that Gale speed. And here. Yeah, in theory we want to have a scout with Gale speed, right? We also have a couple of generals, and the trick to for them to gain experience is, well, they don't gain experience. Okay, we just have them. I thought they would maybe gain experience if they are somewhere stationed. It seems like they are not. It's kind of a bummer, as the ship captains gain some experience. And I thought it would work the same way, but no, of course not. Of course not. Like, just a little bit, not that much, but just like a little bit of trickling in. Well, they need to give them something like maneuvers, and then, like just in EU, was it in EU? I thought everyone gains a little bit of experience. The troops gain a little bit, just a little bit, and also the generals gain a little bit. That would be fine. Built that now? Yeah, we have built that. That's good.
Scientific progress attained.
Very good. Let's see. And this is coming. Yeah, we're getting there. And here we're at 98%. Very, very good, very good. Energy credits from jobs increase, and how about some more shield hit points? Wow, the Illyrians are already there. Meta compression. More armor, and now more minerals again. Just very good. How is this going forward? We're getting there as well. Yeah, that's for that we keep the tons of alloys in our bucket. Gateway ready! Yay! Ah, yeah. I want to fly over to the L-gate too, so we have a direct other connection to the L-gate, except the L-gate. And maybe we want that, like, here. So we'll just fly over for now. just have access to that. We don't want to build anything there yet. Only if we run out of room. But yeah, it's important to have a gate there. Just directly connected, not only through L-gate, but through everything. The multi-gate thing, because with the L-gate you fly to the L cluster and then you fly back. It's kind of odd. Hey, insulting. Yeah. Tragic existence, whatever. We don't care, Antomatons. You also have a tragic existence now that you've got the aggression of one of the strongest opponents that we have here, the Elven Socialist Commonwealth. They have the high weight, and mostly from fleet power. They have the same amount of points from fleet power as the Antomaton Swarm, which makes them
construction finalized.
Go into a precarious position. Interstellar expansion. One more starbase capacity. Yay! I'm not sure. Some food from Jobs would be okay. Comrade starbase. Yeah, we need to do something there.
Construction finalized.
Full trading company is not that great, right? But the deep space black site is. We need that. Prosperity starbase. It's about the same. And the Ascension starbase. Yeah, here we can go with the Hyperlane Registrar now. Then the Star Fortress. Dyson Sphere Construction! Harnessing the power of the stars. Here we go. It's been a dream of human engineers throughout history. From crude combustion to the pale imitation of solar fusion, we now stand ready to realize this dream. The closed red eye system, it will be closed soon, from the Dyson Sphere, sits the scaffold upon which we will build a Dyson Sphere encompassing closed red eye and monopolizing the cataclysmic power of the star. Start the frame. Now we can go for the construction site that is ready. The gateway construction site in the Oblion system. Can activate that as well. And yeah, more things are coming. So we're building again 3 megastructures. One of them here. Alien megastructure. Oh yeah, a testament to the ingenuity of intelligent life. Dagor Quende. It's not time for open conflict. And the Mada Ular are coming. What? We've discovered that you're building a Dyson Sphere around a central star and most one of our most beloved constellations, the One-Eyed Wanderer. What are you talking about? The Wanderer has watched over our kind since the beginning of time. With her single eye, she guides not only our fleets, but the stars themselves. Oh, they are spiritual seekers now. In the journey across the sky, and now you have built a sphere around it, blinding her. It will take many years before we can tell the difference from here. The notion that she won't be watching over future generations has shaken our people, and they deserve a formal apology. We could share some of our energy with them. But we are not sorry. We'll share some of our energy. We'll go up and beyond. 1,000 energy is nothing for us. Or are they getting that monthly now? I hope not. Monthly trades. 1000. In an attempt to repair some of the damage done to the relation between our empire and the Mada Ula, following the construction of a Dyson sphere around their most beloved stars, our most equal traveled all the way to their homeworld to deliver a sincere apology to their people. Though it may take them some time to recover from their loss, they appreciated that we made an effort. Hopefully, from now on, the relations between our empires will only improve. Do we have a trade in there now for 1,000 per month? Can we see that somewhere? Is there a trade going on now? I hope not. They are improving our relations. Okay, they like us for some reason now.
Ships upgraded.
Commercial pact research. No, thankfully not. It was just a one-time payment. Up and beyond. Soviet speed force has been upgraded. Yeah, everyone's a little bit more powerful then. So it's quite nice. Yeah, we still need a lot of it. 92 days. The Sentry Spire. Yeah, that is not so important, but it's very useful. Open borders from the Evaxian Nation. Hey there, Evaxian Nation. Hegemonic imperialists. Have you changed? Yeah, that's fine. Senate floor is in session.
Construction finalized.
Peak of power starbase. Oh, nice. Yeah, we want to upgrade this. Let's see what we can get there. I think we'll go into shipyards now. We want to have shipyards everywhere. Some reserve decentralized shipyard thing. It's going to be great. 54 days. My friends, 54 days. What's happened now? Whew. Elven Socialist Commonwealth has called their council veto, failed the resolution, change council size to 4. Ah! The freaks. We just need to get better. And support the Tianqi, my goodness me. How's our diplomatic weight going? We're getting there. Slowly, slowly though. The Mushmush are even better at this. They're sending in everything they have. I mean, we could maybe do so too. Like a surprise takeover, we'll send all of our lois there. It increases. Nice. They're getting the warp beasts in check again. And we're getting more trade. Very good. Crook's coin's also having fun with their new habitats. That's fine. How much? Oh my goodness me! That we cannot afford that anymore. Sacrosanct Verbum later vassalized the nation. Okay. Oh, that's fine now. 14! Are you kidding me? Wait! Okay. Sentry aerials. But it seems like we're getting only this little message. Okay. Well, let's have a look at it, at least. Has now antennas. It looks pretty good already. And it will soon be finished, we think. The Sentry Array. From everywhere, all near the finest scouts are sent in here to look at the galaxy and its proceedings.
Together we will build a brighter future.
And they will try to predict the movements of the enemy in the future. Shield harmonics, more shield hit points, great stuff. Energy weapon damage. Getting in there. We're getting in there. How are we in our interstellar friendship? Yeah. Slowly. Slowly, slowly, slowly. At least in the economy, we are up and beyond. We will do even more once we begin with the ring worlds. Once we begin with the ring worlds, we'll also have enough to we'll get our fleet going enough time. We have got this, and we've got this. 425 days only. Anymore. And then our ships will be a lot quicker again. It's just super great. Gateway construction is ready, and here, yeah, we have the Dyson Sphere. That's slowly doing something. Deep space construction site for the planned gateway in the Gate Bride of Equality system is now in place. Once we have the necessary resources, yeah, we have them. Go for the gateway. We have a gate here. A gate here in construction. But we'll stay here with the Bright Spirit. I think that's best. That we don't need anymore here, so we can start with gate production. We can start a gate like here. And look at this, we're still missing two. Two science ships that could increase our research. Come on, we need these science ships. Where can we build them? Can we build them here? No, actually not. Need to build them elsewhere. Was probably here. Here we go. Yeah, that will make a huge difference, as these are really research stations, and they will improve now research output by quite a significant bit.
Our research has progressed.
Very good. More food from jobs, and now back to the edict duration, I guess. Extraction patterns, more minerals from jobs, and let's go for the armor hit points again. Here we go. Building the gates. The gates are coming. Once we have the gate system in place, we'll be in a very good spot. All that framework down. It's not for nothing. It's for something. It's for the power of the progress. Speaking about that. No, there's no one available here. Let's look for other talents, like you. Schmuppi Prip. I think that's a fantastic name. Him over. And send Schmuppi Prip. Over to their crib. Here we go. Yeah, I mean, We'll get there in time. Oh, we can hire him. Synthetics are always so reliable. I'm not so thrilled by the others, so we'll just wait there for them. I'll just have a look at the leaders, if there's anyone really, really good. That's kind of nice. Oh, there's a new decision. Allow organic slave trade? No. What is that? Repeal 5-year plans. No! 5-year plans are really good. We're at 990 now. We'll see how that expands, or if it expands. Hey there! New Mystic Order, show us your wares. Our most trusted guardship. She was chosen by the goddess herself. To escort our blessed cargo across the galaxy. And has thwarted many a blasphemer in her day. Pirates, infidels, monsters of the void. All who interfere with Numa's divine path. And she's almost as good as new. She's served fortune well, and now for a modest donation she may also serve you. And as always, in time to consider, we can notify you before we depart your territory. Give you one more chance to accept the goddess' generous offer. Well, we'll just to find out we want to do that. Blessings upon you, humans, for your business brings us closer to the goddess. Let's see. It's fortune's favor, let's see. Oh, goodness me. Yeah, she's good at the beginning, I'm no doubt, but... oh, well, yeah. How quick is she, though? She's relatively quick. We can have that going. We'll have her join the Soviet strike force. Yeah, the ragtag band of everything. For the goddess, my friends. For the goddess. What a great thing to have. Slowly getting there. Mineral com. Yeah, we need something there. Let's see. Yeah, we need something bigger there. So we need administration offices here. Here as well. Have a little bit of stuff going before we need it. The luxury position that we can do that. Yeah, the consumer culture. We'll have them going around here. Need a little bit more workplaces, so civilian industries. And here we can start with something else. How about more rare crystals?
Together we will build a brighter future. This.
Knowledge 30, yeah. And improve that a bit. And then Psycorps going. We need the Psycorps too. Something else coming in. Focusing arrays, yes. And more energy weapon attack speed. And here? What will be here? Space Amoeba Protection Act. Yes, of course. We're behind that so much. Join us. Ah, yeah, we need another space station. Look at us here. What's this? The war aliens? Ah, that's, of course, yeah, that's the Kermans. Yagen Shroompire. Oh, the sleepers awake! Now. Where are the sleepers? Here, the City Mutters Peacekeepers. It's time. It was time that something happened. It began as a subtle shift in City Mutton behavior. Scattered reports of their ships, once rarely seen outside their own space. Now being spotted in remote systems all across the galaxy, highly advanced scouting vessels. Visiting ancient ruined worlds, refusing all hails and fleeing when attacked. Their purpose and mission unknown. Until now. We now know that the City Mutters were preparing, recovering the databanks of survey beacons and automated scouting posts left behind when they retreated to their present borders, gathering information for their return to the galactic stage. In City Mutters space, fleets are gathering, armies are being mustered, and ancient factories roar to life. For the first time in an age, the City Mutters peacekeepers are looking outwards, beyond their borders and towards the galaxy at large. As the decaying shipyards are repaired and refitted, and the dormant systems of Titan foundries come online, the rest of the galaxy is left with only one question. Who will this once sleeping giant target first in their quest to reclaim age-old glory lost giants in the playground? And they're kind of good with us. Oh, it's about time that they awaken. Before they get irrelevant. Now they have a pretty good fleet. Pretty good fleet. Not as big as the Automatons, but still. There's something to them. They can use the subjugation casus belli against us. Hopefully not against us, right? They could attack maybe probably the Holy Vaxian League. They are like their first opponent. I guess they're still on purification. So, I just guess that's going to be a first target, a probable first target. Whoop, City Mutters, hey there, we have allowed you to move about freely in our territory for too long. Today we draw the line. They're arrogant now. And supremacist. Oh, come on. We can request to become a signatory. No. Oh, my goodness me. Yeah. Their diplomatic weight is exploding. How strong are they? Well, they have these fleets now. It's good, but not overwhelming. Peak of power starbase. Yeah, the Siplim station. I'd like to have a fleet academy there. Then we can upgrade. Shupan leveled up. Nice. Stubborn, still progressing. Our 500 days.
Our research has progressed.
50 days. Proclamation broadcasts. 10% more edict duration.
Discourse seeding in progress.
Add another starbase. Critic center. Yeah, the factory stations. It's all getting a little bit crammed as we are stopping the production of habitats. And their expansions, so... But the gates have priority now. The gates have priority now. On the Galactic Council. I know. Slowly getting there. The Yagen Shroompire is now also Federation Builders. What changed them? Wow! I think we converted them, of course. Vladislav Dragomiro has new skills. Yeah, skills. He's paranoid. He has a higher chance of, I think, rare technologies. Dangerous. That's about the paranoid people. They're fascinated by that. Yegor Kuzin. Also quite good. 69 minerals in the hive of old. 69 minerals in the hive of old. What are they doing now? Nothing yet. Not yet. Not yet. Still have good relations with them, but Accord Orknakter. Yeah, yeah. Sunny Socialism. Starbase has finished the construction queue. We're just gonna make trade safer. And have a deep space black site. Here we go. Caravaneers, old with defects. Oh, what is that? A starbase in the Soyuz gate system reports that the Winds of Fortune fleet has evacuated and abandoned a decrepit ship now in unstable orbit around the system's central star. One man's trash.
Situation log updated.
Search it. It's gonna be fun. Where is it gonna be? We can just search it here, I guess, okay. Let's send him. How can we search it? Oh, a construction ship we need. Okay, okay. Building something? Can we be there quickly? How quickly can we be there? Ooh, it seems like relatively quick. Very good. A decrepit ship.
Build a brighter future.
Nice. Flash coolant, energy weapon attack speed plus 5%. And how about something of this? I don't know. Bonus on these. Bonus on these. Bonus on these. Yeah, let's go for shields. Let's go for shields. And matter compression. More hit points. Let's see if we have something here. No. And I mean, we really need to improve the strike crafts as well. And look, the defense platform damage, we have something there. And that will help us catch up. And we'll also be good in the long run. So we're just going for defense platform damage now or something like that. Even though maybe strike craft are better. Yeah, let's go for strike craft. Strike craft also helps our ships. The thing is, with researching what they already have, is catching up to them in technology, and then we're going to have more diplomatic points than them. And if it also has some use, then we can do it. If it doesn't have use for us, we won't do it. Because we have other means that could be good there. Ah, look, 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 it's coming. Strategic coordination centers, building. Building and building, and soon, soon. Soon we'll have it coming. That is full. Minus 20 housing, people still there. Overcrowding, minus 10.5. Someday we'll need to get in there and just ship the people over, then after 10 years we'll change it back again. Energy credits, we need to buy something. Oh look, that has fallen thankfully. What do we need? rare crystals would be okay. We have enough volatile modes. We could buy some throw. Doesn't hurt, let's buy some throw. Some bribing materials. Some of this. Here we go. Look at the Dreisesser. They seem to be topping Sol soon. Ah, now. Strategic Coordination Center. Comms station. No, that's the Lane station. It's... Where do we have it now? I always don't find it. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Is that it? No, it's not it. Here we go. Powerful communications arrays have been added to the Strategic Coordination Center, enabling our strategists to issue orders to our ships throughout the galaxy. These state-of-the-art arrays are powerful enough to burn through any possible jamming. The quantum entangled signal is utterly unhackable. Excellent. And of course, there's more! Only 1,800 days. Woo! It's gonna be crazy. Crazy good. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other in the next episode when we, probably do something else earth-shattering, right? We should finally catch up to them, but that will be some time. Even though we're in a good place, we're building like all the galactic wonders now, and then we'll see what we can do. Have a great time until then, and happy gaming. This is Emmanuel Kahn signing out. See you soon, and happy gaming.